Welcome to the engineering video series. This tutorial introduces how to develop add-in functions for any type of analyses in the GeoStudio product suite. This tutorial is based on materials provided in the GeoStudio add-in developers kit on the GeoSLOPE website. Let's get started by reviewing a few terms related to the development of computer programs. In computer programming, a field is a variable. A method is a set of operations that fulfill a particular objective. A parameter, also referred to as an argument, is a value passed between methods. The method passing the value is referred to as the calling method. A class is a declaration of what a specific instance of the class can do. A class has both properties and behaviors, which are defined by the included fields and methods. An individual instance of a class is called an object. An example of an object is a boundary condition applied to a specific node at a specific time. Now that we've reviewed these general terms, let's consider what an add-in function is. In general, an add-in function is a user-defined relationship. This relationship may follow the form y is equal to f of x, where the value of y is determined based on the value of x given the add-in function f. An add-in function can be used in place of an internal GeoStudio function. Internal GeoStudio functions include material property functions and boundary condition functions. Add-ins are incorporated into any GeoStudio analysis as a supplemental function run by the solver. The purpose of using an add-in function in GeoStudio is to specify an alternative to boundary condition functions or material properties functions. Boundary condition add-in functions are applied to geometry items such as points or lines. An example of an add-in function that could be developed for a boundary condition is a function specifying the total head in a reservoir that changes with time over the simulated period. Material properties functions are applied to regions. An alternative material function could be implemented with an add-in function if the simulated soil exhibits changing strength over time or distance. An add-in function can also replace the existing constitutive models for stress-strain relationships in sigma W. For example, if the elastic plastic and modified cam clay methods do not fit the simulated scenario. This is an example of a more sophisticated add-in function. The add-in is called by a method within the GeoStudio solver. First, the GeoStudio solver automatically passes the x value to the add-in. This is the parameter or argument being passed into the method. The add-in may also request more data from the solver about its current context, such as the current elevation being solved for. With this information, the add-in function determines y and returns it to the solver. Note that the data type of the x and y variables depends on the GeoStudio function the add-in is replacing. An add-in function follows the general format illustrated on the right. The key elements of an add-in are the name of the add-in, or the declaration of a class, the method or function of the add-in, which must be called calculate and is the portion of the code that determines the value of y based on the inputs, and a return command which can be used to send the y variable back to the GeoStudio solver. Both the class and the calculation method must be public in order for the GeoStudio solver to see them when scanning an add-in. When a variable name or field is declared as public, this field will appear in the GeoStudio define view under key in functions. An add-in function can be created in two general ways. First of all, the add-in code can be written in a text editor, like Notepad. This method is better for simple add-in functions where it is not difficult to find errors and debug the code. The second method of creating add-in code is in an integrated development environment, like Microsoft Visual Studio. This method is better for complex add-in functions where there are many steps or functions in the same code file. Add-ins can be written in any common language runtime coding language, like F#, C#, and C++. The generated code must be converted to the appropriate format in order to be called by GeoStudio. A computer language compiler is used for the conversion. A compiler is a computer program that transforms source code written in the source language into another computer language called the target language. All Windows-based computers include a compiler installed with Microsoft's .NET runtime. This means that no additional program is required to compile an add-in file. Compiled code containing an add-in function is called an assembly. The assembly is stored in a dynamic link library file, which is in the machine language. We will now review how to create an add-in function in Notepad and compile the code into the correct format. Here is a simple add-in written in Notepad. The purpose of this function is to generate a sine curve, which could be used as a boundary condition in many of the GeoStudio products. As you can see here, the name of the add-in is sine curve. Below this is a list of variables that have been declared as public. All public variables can be seen as fields in the GeoStudio analysis when this add-in is selected. This means that the values for the initial amplitude, maximum amplitude, and wavelength used in the sine function can all be specified in the GeoStudio analysis. Below the public variables is the calculate method called by the GeoStudio solver. First, the variable that will be returned to the solver is declared. For simplicity, this variable was called y. Any other variables that will be used to calculate the value of y may also be declared here. Note that these variables do not include the word public and therefore will not be visible in the GeoStudio analysis. The value of y is then calculated given the value of x and the specified variables. The resulting y value is returned to the solver. As you can see, some basic knowledge of code development is required for building add-ins. However, there are many example add-in functions provided in the Add-in Software Development Kit on the GeoSlope website. We will save the add-in as a code script file by going to Save As and adding the .cs extension to the end of the file name. We are now ready to compile the code. The Add-in Developers Kit on the GeoSlope website includes a simple program that runs a C# compiler. I have already downloaded the Developers Kit from the website. The program is called GS-Add-in and contains the appropriate settings for creating an add-in assembly file from a CodeScript file. I will copy and paste this program into the folder containing my sine curve CodeScript file. When I open the GS-Add-in program, I see the location where the compiled file will be saved at the top of the command window. Below this is the prompt add-in name. When I type sine curve and hit enter, the CodeScript sine curve file will be compiled into a dynamic link library file. When I hit enter again, the command window disappears, and I can see that the newly compiled sine curve code with the extension .dll for dynamic link library has appeared in my add-in functions folder. Note that the CodeScript file you wish to compile must be saved in the same location as the compiler program GS-Add-in. I will now demonstrate how to access an add-in function from a GeoStudio analysis. Here we have a TempW analysis that has been developed to evaluate the depth of frost penetration due to changes in surface temperature around a newly installed culvert. I will first go to Edit, Options, in order to make sure that the GeoStudio analysis is retrieving add-in functions from the desired location. The add-in folder shown here is where I saved the sine curve file, so I do not need to change this location. However, if the sine curve file was saved in a different location, I can click on Browse to find the folder containing my add-in functions. I will be using the sine curve function to specify the boundary condition at the ground surface. In order to do so, I will go to Key In, Boundary Conditions. A ground surface boundary condition was previously established with a constant temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. I will now change this boundary condition so that it is a function. I will click on the ellipsis symbol to open the Key In Thermal Boundary Functions window. I will click on Add and select New to create a new boundary condition function. I will name the boundary condition function Sinusoidal Ground Temperature. I will then select Add-in Function from the list of function types. A select button appears, allowing me to choose the add-in I wish to use for the boundary condition function. The sine curve add-in is listed in the browser window. I will select it and press OK. As soon as the sine curve add-in is selected, three fields appear at the bottom of the window. These are the three fields that were declared public in the sine curve code. I can now specify values for each of these fields. After entering values for each field, the sinusoidal temperature trend that will be applied to the ground surface is illustrated in the graph window. I will now close the thermal boundary functions window and will make sure that the sinusoidal ground temperature function is selected for the boundary function. As you can see, this boundary condition has already been applied to the top of the model domain. We are now ready to solve the analysis. Once the analysis has finished solving, I can check that the sinusoidal temperatures were applied to the ground surface by going to Draw Graph. I've already created a plot of temperature over time at the ground surface nodes. As you can see, the simulated temperatures follow the boundary condition function that was created using the sine curve AddIn function. In summary, AddIn functions can replace internal GeoStudio functions, allowing for greater flexibility for specifying material behavior and boundary conditions, particularly when the material or boundary condition varies dynamically with the analysis state. AddIn functions can range in complexity from very simple to highly involved functions. AddIns can be written in any CLR language. The code is then compiled into the machine language so it can be called by the GeoStudio solver. The developed AddIn functions are accessible from any GeoStudio analysis when they are placed in the specified directory, as demonstrated in this video. We have now reached the end of this tutorial. Note that not all of the powerful capabilities of AddIn functions have been discussed here. Please see the AddIn software development kit available on the GeoSLOPE website for more information. Thank you for watching.